If you like, the king is called as a god and savior. If you don't like, the same guy is called as dictator. That's the mind. Same way, this truth which I am going to express now, if you like, you can take this as a compassionate revelation, or you can say, rule for exploiting. It's your mind. But as a factual reality, it is a compassionate revelation. Enlightenment or any spiritual growth is discretionary gift by master. There is no law with which you can earn it. To certain level, that feeling good can be earned by some laws, rules, sadhanas and all. But that solid experience itself is a clear discretionary gift from the master. When you stand by me or do what I am saying based on some of your understandings or your own concepts, all this time you lived based on your concepts. You did not do because I said. You did it because it matched with your ideas. Only when you do something which I am saying which does not match your idea, you take the jump into the surrender, bhakti, and enlightenment happens in you. You put your feet directly into enlightenment. But always the guidance from the master will be dharma in the large picture when you look. Unfortunately, you don't get to see that large picture before you enter into that enlightened state, space. So this is a fight goes on for ages. And again I happen to enjoy few people not even standing by dharma, few people getting caught in what they call as dharma, few people jumping beyond that and entering into moksha.
Trust in you, 'cause you know it's best for me to lead a blissful life, a life with no more strife. I can't believe the things I do, just to spend a little time with you. Nothing will compare, I know you will take care.
You're always showing us compassion, your love is endless like an ocean. Nithyananda, Nithyananda, my life's become a meditation. Never since we had a deep connection,